Hello students, welcome to UVN Academy. In the UVN Academy, our purpose is to accelerate your physics. And we'll be starting with the concept of term of the day. So, to begin with, we are choosing a very important term. The term that you have used the most in this year. Which word have we used the most in this year is perhaps corona. So, one such corona is in physics as well. So, we are starting with the term of the day, or the term of the year, or perhaps the millennium. It is a corona discharge. Some of you might have heard about it, and some of you might not have heard, because the principle behind the corona discharge is no longer in the CBSE syllabus. But we will be discussing this term because it is very important from the entrance point of view. So, what is corona discharge? To come to that term, we first of all take the two spheres. Let us consider two spheres, one of the bigger radius, say R1, another of the smaller radius, say R2. Connect them with a conducting wire and give some charge to the system. Now what will happen? If I give Q charge to the system, the charge will be distributed on both of them because they have been connected by a conducting wire, so the charge will flow from the sphere A to the sphere B till both of them come to the same common potential. So the concept is, we all know that the conductors have the same potential throughout. So when you connect one sphere with another sphere with a conducting wire, this whole system becomes one conducting surface. And the potential of both the surfaces should be same. So the potential of the sphere 1 is, say, after the redistribution of the charge Q, if we have given Q charge to the entire system, and after redistribution, if the charge on the sphere Q1A, on the sphere A is Q1, and on the sphere B, it is Q2. So when this charge is Q1, which is distributed over the entire sphere A, and the charge Q2, which is distributed on the entire sphere B, but since they have been connected by a conducting wire, the potential of both of them should be same. So V1 should be equal to V2. Now what is V1? V1 is KQ by R1. We can write it like this. And you can also write it as, what is K? K is actually 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. All of you must be aware of epsilon naught. So it is Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R1 and Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R2. Now, is it clear to every one of you? Can you see these formulae clearly? This is KQ1 by R1 should be equal to KQ2 by R2. Now, if I bring this expression, multiply it with some thing like this, so that it comes out to be 4 pi epsilon naught R1 square into R1, and this is equal to Q2 into R2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R2 square. So what I have done, I have multiplied the left hand side and divided the left hand side with R1, and multiplied and divided the right hand side with R2. So now what is this Q by 4 pi R1 square? And here Q2 upon 4 pi R2 square, this can be called as a charge density of the first sphere, that is sigma 1. What is sigma? Sigma is generally the charge density, and we can write the general expression for sigma is charge per unit area. So charge on the first sphere is Q1, area of the first sphere is 4 pi R1 square. I can cancel the, I have taken epsilon naught outside. So, you can cancel the epsilon naught on both the sides. So, it comes out to be sigma 1 R1 is equal to sigma 2 R2. So, sigma 1 will be equal to Q1 by 4 pi R1 square. And sigma 2 is equal to Q2 upon 4 pi R2 square. So, if you are not able to see, just let me know. Everything is clear. We can give you the screenshots of this also later on. If you are not clear, we can give you the screenshot of this board. Now, we come to the conclusion that sigma 1 is equal to sigma 2 r2. And this is basically valid for all the surfaces. If you connect 3-4 conducting spheres, it will be sigma 1 r1 will be equal to sigma 2 r2 will be equal to sigma 3 r3 and so on. So in general, we can write sigma r is equal to constant, that is charge density into the radius will be constant throughout because the potential V1 will be equal to potential V2. Or in general sense, I can say sigma is inversely proportional to R. So now this is a very important formula, that charge density is inversely proportional to the radius of curvature. What do we mean by this? We mean by this that suppose I have a single conducting surface of the irregular surface area. There's some portion whose radius is more and some portions whose radius is less. Suppose this is a flatter one and I give some charge to this irregularly shaped conductor. So now the distribution of the charge will be in such a way that the potential throughout has to be the same, because we know that this is a very important property of conductor, that at every point of the conductor the potential has to be the same. So now, if I give charge to this surface, the charge redistribution will take place in such a way that the potential throughout is same, and in such a way, keeping in mind that sigma will be inversely proportional to R, which means that in the regions where the area is, which basically belong to the sphere of larger radius of curvature, you can assume this part A, C, B as a part of the sphere whose radius is very large. So its sigma will be less. And you can consider this portion, say D, F, anything, say G. So D, F, G is a portion where the radius is less. So D, F, G belongs to the sphere of the smaller radii of curvature, radius of curvature, and A, C, B belongs to the surface of larger radius of curvature. So now what happens? The charge density here will be less and charge density here will be more, because sigma is inversely proportional to R. If I keep on changing the shape in such a way that finally I get a conductor like a cone shaped conductor. Do you know what is the literal meaning of corona? The literal meaning of corona is basically the crown shape. In one case we can have the crown shape, another corona is that which is found in the solar sun's outer area is also known as corona, where we have got a large amount of the gaseous, rarefied gaseous envelope is there. So the envelope outside the sun is also known as corona. But here what we refer to corona is that it will be basically crown shape. So what is crown shape? If I take a conductor like this, which is cone shaped. Now if I give some charge to this conductor, suppose I connect it with a battery. Of say 10^3 volt or something like that. Now what will happen? The charge will be distributed on this conductor, and at the pointed ends of the conductor the charge density will be significantly high. And if the charge density is significantly high, now we know that the field just outside the conductor is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. These are the 2-3 things that you need to remember. The first key point that we have used is that potential at all the points of conductor is same. Then second thing that we came to know is that charge sigma r at throughout the conducting surface will always be constant. And the third important point is that field just outside the conductor is sigma upon epsilon naught, just outside. So these are the points that we need to remember about the conductor. Fine. So now the sigma, if E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, then at these pointed ends of the conductor, the because of the relation, sigma is inversely proportional to R, sigma will be very high because the radius of curvature is negligibly small. And since E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, so the field just outside this comb-shaped conductor is going to be very high. Now what is the effect or impact of this very high field just outside the conductor? just outside the conductor, if the field is very high, the dielectric breakdown of the surrounding air will take place. You know that air in the normal condition is an insulator, but any insulator is insulator only in the normal condition. In extreme conditions of high electric field, low pressure, high temperature, the insulator becomes a conductor. So that depends on the strength of that particular insulator. So the dielectric strength of air is approximately 3×10⁻⁶ volt per meter. So that when the field just outside the conductor becomes too high and it crosses the dielectric strength of the air, the dielectric breakdown of air will take place. So you know what do you mean by the breakdown? The breakdown means the air will become conducting. When the air will become conducting, the air will get ionized. So air will get ionized into positive and negative ions. So positive ions of the conductor will be attracted towards the negative ions of the air and they will jump. The normal jump that you come across, and when you read in the books, you come across the language that the charge jumps from the conductor into the air. What do you mean by jumps? When the charge jumps off the conductor into the air, it is possible only when the air becomes conducting, because air is normally an insulator. So insulator does not conduct or does not allow the flow of charges through it. So when the air, the dielectric breakdown of air takes place, the charge jumps off the conductor into the air after the dielectric breakdown. Students, if you will need, we will give you the notes of this after the session is over. So the charge will jump off the conductor into the air, the dielectric breakdown of air takes place, and whenever the charge jumps off means the charge is accelerated, and accelerated charge is the source of EM waves. These are the various points in this one concept of corona discharge. What all we are going to study is that the potential at all the points, some concepts we have utilized and some we are concluding. That is, the potential at all the points of conductor is going to be the same. Sigma throughout the conductor has to be the constant. Field just outside the conductor, we know, has to be the sigma upon epsilon naught. And just outside the comb-shaped conductor, the field should exceed the dielectric strength. And in another term here, we have dielectric breakdown of air will take place. And the charge will jump off the conductor into the air. And this jumping is whenever you jump, you are not in the normal state, you are not still, you are not moving with the constant velocity. Jumping means the charge is accelerated, and accelerated charge particle, you will read in the next chapters of EM waves, that accelerated charge is a source of EM waves. So when this charge jumps from the conductor into the air, this is accompanied with the visible glow, and that visible glow is known as the corona discharge. So this visible glow is there. So ultimately I conclude the whole term corona discharge in a way. You can write down if you want to write down, or else we'll give you the notes. So what is corona discharge and how does it take place, and what is basically the use of corona discharge, that also I'll tell you. So the first thing is, whenever we give charge to an irregularly shaped conductor, the distribution of the charge is always in such a way that the potential at all the points of the conductor is same, and the charge density is inversely proportional to the radius of curvature. So in the portions where the radius is more, the charge density is less, and in the regions where the radius is very small, the charge density becomes very high. And then since charge density becomes very high, since E is E sigma upon epsilon naught, when the charge density becomes very high, the field in the surrounding region becomes very high, and when this field strength increases, the dielectric strength of the surrounding medium, the medium can be anything other than air also, if you enclose this comb shaped conductor in some other chamber also where you have fit some other gases dielectric strength is less. If you want coronary star, then we deliberately choose the gas whose dielectric strength is low and the breakdown takes place and the smaller fields. So when the breakdown of the air takes place, the charge jumps off the conductor into the surrounding medium, and this charge, since it is accelerated, so it gives out the EM waves. And when some of the EM waves lie in the visible region, we are able to see the visible glow. Even the glow, it is different for the different kinds of gases, for helium, for hydrogen, for air. The color of the glow is different. It's a very interesting phenomena. One, and this corona discharge is the principle behind the Van de Graaff generator. So Van de Graaff generator is no longer in the 12th class syllabus. It's a very important device which is used to produce the potential differences of very high volt. So the underlying principle behind the Van de Graaff generator is the corona discharge, and this is used to produce a potential difference of very high volt of the order of 3 into 10 to the power 6 volt, and the dielectric strength of air, you will see that if we take a sphere of radius 1 meter, then the dielectric strength of air is 3 into 10 to the power 6 volts per meter. So that's all about the term of the day or the term of the year, or even maybe this term of the millennium also, corona, corona, corona. So now this is a corona discharge in physics, where it is useful, not so harmful, and it is basically accompanied with the visible glow. So we should see a light behind the corona pandemic also, that there must be some light and some learning guidance from the corona pandemic that we need to learn. So this is all about the corona discharge. I hope you like this video. Then subscribe to our channel of UN Academy and press the like button as well. Thank you, students.